Hi, my name is Dave Mothersill. I'm head chef here at the Salt Room in Brighton.
And I'm Raz, and I'm the owner of the Salt Room and the Coal Shed.
How did you do your market research on this area, on Brighton? What made you come here?
Well, I've always lived in Brighton, so this is a natural place to open up. And, you know, I kind of grew up in London and just really wanted to bring a bit of the sort of the London sort of quality down to Brighton, really, which I felt, you know, about 10 years ago, it was kind of really missing, really, and just to kind of bring the levels and the standards up, and, you know, kind of met Dave, and that's how things developed, really.
Okay, so the rest is history as far as that's concerned. Yeah. And Raz, do your customers tell you, what do they tell you that they like most about the Salt Room? What is it that they particularly like about this place here in Brighton?
I think just the quality of the seafood and, you know, the quality and the way it's cooked. I think, you know, I think we're very lucky that the freshness that we get is delivered twice daily, you know, and it literally is from direct from the boats straight out to the customers. And I think, you know, and certainly Dave's take on seafood is, you know, that's what people keep coming back for, really.
So Dave, if I could ask you, how do you teach your staff the species knowledge that they need to know to best represent the products of the dishes that you're presenting to the customers?
Well, I think for me as a chef, obviously spending time in the kitchen and, you know what I mean, just passing on my knowledge to my younger staff and just teaching them all about seasonality. Obviously taking visits to our suppliers as well, which are, you know, Friends of the Sea accredited, using sustainable sort of methods of fishing and just getting them, you know, immersed and involved in what we do here at Salt Room. So it's quite a natural progression for them. If they show sort of willingness and learning, then it's quite easy for them to pick up working with them ingredients every day. So it's sort of, I'd say, quite natural for them to sort of just, you know, pick it up, which is great.
Some of your dishes are quite out there.
Okay.
Would that be fair to say?
If you like.
Some of the ingredients.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we like to use some big flavours with our fish and, you know, Asian ingredients. I wouldn't say are fashionable, but, you know, they do bring, you know, extra flavour and textures to dishes. And, you know, I'm a massive fan of sort of all cuisine, and I think that sort of expresses it through some of the dishes that are currently on the menu here.
When you found out you've been shortlisted in the top 5 sea fish restaurants of the year, how did you feel? Were you surprised or rightly thought, yeah, we deserve to be there, we deserve to be in the top 5?
Well, we've been in the top 10 for the last 2 years, so I think it was super excitement, you know, to get there slowly. And, you know, we've been working very hard to make sure that we are as sustainable and as certified as we can be. So yeah, it was super amazing to kind of know that we're here, really.
And up against some tough competition.
Mm-hmm. Some amazing competition. So, you know, when we first started to think that we could ever, you know, I don't think we could ever dream that we've achieved all these things. So yeah, it'd be super amazing, you know, that we've got here.
We've decided to give you some feedback from the judging day. So there's just one thing that I wanted to show you.
Yeah.
On your judging day. Some of the judges put this document together and they thought that you might like it.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
Amazing.
Yes.
Well, that was amazing. That's great.
How about that?
Eh? Amazing.
Wow.
That's a bit of a surprise, isn't it?
Well done.
Cool, that's great.
Wow.
Wow.
Yeah. Oh no.